management and customer binding programs as a prerequisite for solar district heating.
Let me introduce myself. I'm an engineer and mainly work on planning feasibilities and tender documents for in the field of district heating and energy efficiency in buildings. I'm mainly working for an old Austrian company which is active in the field of all kinds of building techniques. It's the company Altland, which is already 50 years old, and one of the major planners of biomass district heating plants in Austria. So biomass district heating is very well developed in Austria because of several reasons. First, we have a lot of wood, and this initiative was catalyzed at the beginning mainly by wood industry and farmers who prefer to reduce heat from their wood waste instead of selling the wood waste to the paper industry. So we have now, I don't know, please help me, 1,500, 1,800 district heating plants with more than 1 megawatt in Austria. So the experience is quite good. At the moment I'm working in Serbia, in the town of Šabac, where my team and me are planning a biomass boiler who has to be integrated into the existing district heating system. But now I will tell something about demand side management. So not producing energy but saving energy. This field is often neglected and even ignored. It is politically not a very attractive field. So demand sides, what I do on the demand sides very often cannot be seen. It has a completely different psychological character than a boiler, which is a large and expensive building. Demand side management measures consist very often of a high number of very, very small and cheap measures, which as a whole can have a huge effect. We and my colleagues, me too, a little bit later, we speak a lot about technique, but demand side management is very much related also to a different business philosophy and the business strategy. That means, in short words, the relationship with the heat customer, the households, if I speak for a district heating company, is much more important than the production of megawatt hours heat. And in order to build up a good relations, there are several measures necessary. I will speak about them later. This kind of customer relationship has to be reflected also in the management of the district heating company. That means less hierarchies are necessary, more direct procedure of information transport in the district heating company, and after all, a consumer-oriented approach. So this is a summary of important items of the business philosophy of a consumer-oriented district heating system. The managers should try to see the heat supply from the customer side. So, like security of supply, which is very important. Contractual method, fair pricing, technical support, and so on. What has been shown from the practice a good service and a good support of the customer is much more important than the heat price. It could be that gas is individual gas boilers are cheaper than district heating. If district heating manages a very good service for the customers, district heating would be the most successful or most popular heating system in the town. In Vienna we have a very good successful example. Our district heating is not the cheapest system, it is not the most expensive also, but they have a very good marketing and in my opinion the customer service is on a good level. There are different points for information and showrooms where you can inform yourself about energy efficiency. So I think the customers, they feel at home when they are heated by the Vienna's district heating system. So, 20 minutes, no? So, the basis of a customer relationship is actually the bill, the heating bill. Because this means really money, no? And such a bill should be transparent. Transparent in the means that it should be easily understandable. And it should reflect the consumption. In Serbia, this is not the case. In the town of Šabac, where I'm working now, only 11% of the households pay the heat which they have consumed. So they have also the technical elements mounted in the flat which are necessary to measure the consumed heat. 90% of the households don't have this. Consumption-based billing was introduced in Europe in the 60s and 70s, in the neighboring countries in Bulgaria in the year 2000, in Romania about the same time, and why not in Serbia? This is the interesting question. The colleagues from the district heating sector Serbia mentioned social aspects. Actually, social aspects are existing everywhere. If consumption-based billing is not introduced in Serbia, you are already facing problems. For instance, in Šabac, the municipality Šabac implemented in every house new substations, heating substations, has a municipal energy efficiency program through which insulation buildings is financed. But all these energy efficiency measures have much more little effects because consumption-based billing is not implemented. So these investments have much smaller results than actually is the potential. Here this demonstrates the situation. This graphic. It's a view about the fuel demand in Šabac. Upper peak is biomass. The biomass consumption is constant. The boiler will work on a constant level of capacity and the gas consumption goes less and less. And this is mainly due to the implementation of consumption-based billing, if it will be done in the next 2 years. And this is the situation if it is not done. The gas consumption is 80% higher all over the next 10 or 20 years. Huh? So this means also a lot of expenditure cost for the municipality, which is not the richest one, and shows very well the impact of consumption based. I would like to show about some load philosophies of the district heating method. District heating systems which have implications regarding demand side management. We have radial system, you can see on the scheme on the website. loop system, a loop system, which you can see here. These are some implications of demand side management. A load dispatch in a linear system is not possible. You're dependent from heat source actually, central heat source. And in the loop system, you can have several boilers, which is a much more stable system. And results also regarding sizing network in smaller dimensions of the heating pipes, and then a more stable system. And actually, regarding reserve capacity, much less additional boilers which are necessary for reserve and backup. Yeah, some aspects to the technical measures regarding the demand side. Here, this graphic, you see a comparison of the cost of a saved kilowatt hours with the cost of a produced kilowatt hour. If the saved kilowatt hour is cheaper than the produced one, then you should produce megawatts. That means save energy, which is cheaper than producing energy. On the other side, insulation, especially windows, are very expensive and often much more expensive than the produced heat. In this case, subsidies are paid for the investors, like it is done in the municipality of Scharwitz. All these measures, which are much cheaper than the produced kilowatt hours, should be realized before you extend your heat production capacity. Dimensioning of the components of the heating system in buildings. These are results in the table from a study from Germany from 2010. It's an Optimum study. It's quite famous in Austria because it is a very well performed study, which analyzed the saving potentials in buildings regarding the right dimensioning of heating components. And what is interesting, in the so-called perfect Germany, most components are rather over-dimensioned. So valves are 7 to 10 times, radiators 1.7 times, 2 times larger than should be. Pumps up to 8 times. That means a lot of unnecessary electricity consumption. The heat source, this could be the substation or a boiler, nearly 2 times larger than necessary. So the estimated efficiency potential from resulting from this situation is between 50% and 30%. It's quite large. The investments are not so high because these components are not the most expensive one, and you can more or less achieve payback periods beyond 10 years or even 5 years. So these measures should be realized before I plan additional capacities in a district heating system. Yeah, demand side does not only mean technical measures to reduce, to save energy and raise the energy efficiency. These are also complex strategy and philosophies how to reduce, how to strengthen the efficiency of the whole system. Heat service, for instance, is an interesting strategy. Heat service means the district heating system is not selling heat for megawatt hours. The district heating company guarantees a warm flat, let's say with 20, a minimum temperature, 20 centigrade. And how this is achieved? This is the problem of the district heating company. So they could, instead of producing and supplying heat, they could also save energy. And so in the buildings, make the efficiency better of the system, so they could deliver less heat, but which is compensated by higher energy efficiency. This system is, I like it a lot, but it is not very relevant. Few smaller district heating companies are working with this because it is very, it needs really high efforts from the staff of the district heating company and the municipality. So it's a quite idealistic business variant. The nearest town where aspects of heat services since many years are realized is the Hungarian town Debrecen, which is one of the pioneers in energy efficiency and customer service in Middle Europe. It's not very known. And in Germany, a town which is performing all aspects of heat service is Rothenburg, of the tower. It's a nice middle-aged small town. Yeah, load shifting. Load shifting is a very important measure to save energy, actually to produce in a smooth and regular way heat. Here you see a load profile of throughout the day of a boiler. In the morning and the evening you have peaks. Means this is the time when the people use hot water or switch on the heating system, and during night, of course, you have a minimum of consumption, and this means the boiler has to change his capacity non-stop during the day, which is which is very bad for the lifetime of the boiler. So it is an expensive, at the end, it is an expensive way to operate a boiler, and there are several, I have not so much time, several measures how to shift these peak loads and to fill this valley, get a more even production of heat. The main means is a heat accumulator. Here you have a price comparison of a heat accumulator with one megawatt with gas and biomass boiler. So the price of heat accumulator and gas boiler is more or less on the same level. But if you intend to invest in biomass boilers, which are really much more expensive, then heat accumulator is obligatory. Absolutely. Especially because biomass boilers, as you know, anybody who has a coal or wood boiler oven at home knows that these boilers react very slowly when you want to change the heat output. It takes hours sometimes to get hotter or the oven to get colder. So these biomass boilers also are not very flexible, and you could compensate this with a heat accumulator, which has, in the case of biomass, good economical effects. So, these are my coordinates. If you want more information,
thank you, Mr. Baumler.